Hi guys, I hope you're good. Today is day 17 in our Lebanese Arabic 30-day challenge that I'm supposed to be doing with you because I skipped the last 2 days. But I'm gonna make it up, don't worry. This is day 17 and it will be on the playlist so you can, if you started this challenge anyways late, you will have the chance to do it. Yalla, I'm gonna start the lesson. Just I want you to know before I start that today's lesson is going to be a lesson where I just use the Arabic script and I don't use the Latin script. So it's going to be a lesson that is for, intermediate students. Even if you're a beginner, if you can read and write, this lesson can be great for you. And it's a nice lesson that describes a Lebanese and their character traits. Okay, so I took it from a Lebanese advertisement, which I'm going to play with you now. We can play it twice, then I can break it down, and then we can play it again. Okay, yalla, let's begin and let's not make this too long. So the ad is an ad of a bank, although I don't believe in Lebanese banks anymore, but the ad is nice. That's why I'm going to share it with you. Yalla. One second.
حربو
ذكي
حربو
ذكي
مزوي
بضلوا متفائل
كيف عم تكبوا من جوائي
جوكر كريم وشجاع
وين ما بيروح بينجح
وراسه سلمي
الثقافة مهمة كتير بالنسبة له
بيقتل حاله يعلم ولاده وبيستفيد على طول من كل الفرص
إذا منه متعلم ثلاث لغات بيحكي
من كتر ما صار مارق بإيشا صار عنده مناعة
مش بس مناعة قدرة اللبناني عنده قدرة كتير كبيرة
اللبناني قدرته أكبر كتير من ما بتتصور
هاي اللبناني
Okay, I'll play it once more, but I will leave the text open here on the right hand side so you can at least see what they're saying, but we're gonna break it down, of course. Let me first check if the audio is good. If anyone's there, please let me know if the audio is good, if you can hear. Okay, I'm gonna play it once more anyways. Yalla.
حربو
ذكي
مزوي
بضلوا متفائل
كيف عم تكبوا من جوائي
جوكر كريم وشجاع
وين ما بيروح بينجح
وراسه سلمي
الثقافة مهمة كتير بالنسبة له
بيقتل حاله يعلم ولاده وبيستفيد على طول من كل الفرص
إذا منه متعلم ثلاث لغات بيحكي
من كتر ما صار مارق بإيشا صار عنده مناعة
مش بس مناعة قدرة اللبناني عنده قدرة كتير كبيرة
اللبناني قدرته أكبر كتير من ما بتتصور
هاي اللي
Okay, yalla. I'm gonna play each sentence once, slowly, with a slower speed, and then say what they're saying, yalla. Let's put it on 90.
حربو
ذكي
مزوي
بضلوا متفائل
Okay, let's do this so far. حربو. So, حربو is the person who is not smart, but kind of like street smart or savvy. They like they know how to sort their things out. They know how to maybe get away with things. They're savvy and they're street smart. Harbu, harbu. It's a nice word to know. So harbu, that's the masculine form. Of course, in the feminine, you just add a te marbuta and it becomes harbu'a, harbu'a. Okay, so harbu. Masculine, harbu'a, feminine. One second, let me just take this to the left. Okay. Then we have zeki. Zeki yani smart. Just intelligent, zeki. In the feminine form, it's zakiye. So harbu'a with a te marbuta and zakiye. Zakiye, also with a te marbuta, intelligent. Then we have mizwi. Mizwi. Mizwi is related to the word zo, and zo means taste, not the taste of food. No, when you have good taste or bad taste, zo. Mizwi is a person who has a good taste, can be in clothes. Like for example, if somebody wears always nice clothes, I can say shu mizwi. Yani, how good tasted He is, as an adjective, okay? Like he has a good taste in clothes, mizwit. But also, mizwit is a person who has good manners and they have good, like good behavioral manners, like a gentleman or, good manners, mizwit. Okay? So, harbu, zaki, mizwit. For example, if somebody gets me a gift on my birthday, I can say, merci, shou mizwit, mizwit. Okay, in the feminine form, it's mizwa. So if I call and check on people whenever they have a problem or something, they can tell me merci shu mizwa, mizwa, and in the feminine, it's mizwa, mizwa. So that sukun here, I'm putting a kasra instead, mizwa. So mizwa and mizwa. So harbu, street smart, savvy, zaki, intelligent, mizwa, someone who has good taste. And also someone who has good manners and a gentleman and all of that. بيضلوا متفائل. بيضلوا متفائل. Now, بيضل, he stays or he remains. بيضلوا is one of these verbs where you add also the object pronoun to it. So if I remove the O, which is him, it stays, it has the same meaning, بيضل. We don't need to say بيضل. You can say بيضل or بيضلوا. Would be the same. بيضل متفائل. متفائل يعني optimistic. متفائل. And of course, when you add the T مربوطة, متفائلة. متفائل. متفائلة. متفائل. Optimistic. متفائلة. Optimistic in the passive feminine form. So بيضل متفائل. He stays or he remains. Positive, which means he's always positive. Okay, he's always positive. So, harbu, savvy, zaki, intelligent, mizwi, a gentleman, well mannered, bidal metfeal, he's always positive, basically. Next one. Kif ma tkibbu? كيف ما تكبوا بيجواف. If I did a TikTok video on this, I'm gonna leave the link in the description below. كيف ما تكبوا. كيف ما means no matter how. كيف ما. تكب is you throw. تكبوا means you throw him. يعني when you say كيف ما تكبوا, كيف ما تكبوا, no matter how you throw him. كيف ما تكبوا بيجي. بيجي usually means he comes, but in this context it means he ends up. He ends up. بيجي واقف standing. كيف ما تكبوا بيجي واقف. No matter how you throw him, he ends up standing. It's a way to say that someone is very, very resilient, and no matter how hard life is with the is to them, they end up standing on their feet, and they end up, being successful. They end up sorting out their problems and, getting over things, basically. Resilient. كيف ما تكبوا بيجي واقف. This is a nice expression to know, okay? If it's feminine, you say كيف ما تكبا. You add the a in the end. تكبا. كيف ما تكبا. No matter how you throw her. بيجي, instead of بيجي, you of course say بتجي. بتجي. And instead of واقف, you have to say واقف. كيف ما تكبا بتجي واقف. Okay? So, كيف ما تكبوا بيجي واقف. No matter how you throw him, he ends up standing. In the feminine form, it's كيف ما تكبا تجي واقف. Hi guys. Hi Nabila Huria. I was just with them in class. So, let me check if anyone has any questions. Yes. Where it's good. Yes, it means mizwa means like good tasted, well mannered. Yalla, I will continue. So, Karim, yalla, I'm gonna play it first. Let me repeat and we continue.
Bu
zak
mizwa
bdallo metfay
kibat kibbo mizwa
joker Karim.
And this guy said joker instead of joker. He's a joker basically. Okay, let's see this one. Karim u shujaa. Karim yani generous. Of course, in the feminine form, we have to say Karime. I'm a bit conscious about my battery. One second, guys. Let me get my charger. I should have thought about this before. One second.
يلا عم حط الفيش بالشارجور. I'm putting the عم حط الشارجور I mean بالفيش in the plug.
Okay, yalla. So, Karim يعني generous in the feminine form, it's Karime. Karim, Karime. Shujia يعني courageous. Shujia. So, in the feminine form, again, we have to say shujia. So, Karim, courageous, shujia. Karim is generous and shujia يعني courageous, okay? In the feminine form, it's Karime and shujia. And then we have وين ما بيروح بينجح. وين ما يعني wherever. وين ما بيروح, wherever he goes. وين ما بيروح بينجح. بينجح, he succeeds. يلا guys, say them out loud with me, okay? And when we finish, sit down and write these, okay? You have it, you can take a snapshot, you can write them down so that your brain memorizes them. Don't just, yeah, I'm sitting there and listening. No, say it out loud. وين ما بيروح, no matter where he goes. وين ما بيروح بينجح. Of course, you can say it in the feminine form. وين ما بتروح, wherever she goes, بتنجح. بتنجح. Okay. So, كريم, كريمة, generous. شجاع, شجاعة, courageous. وين ما بيروح, wherever he goes, بينجح. He succeeds. Or وين ما بتروح, بتنجح. And then this guy here said, راسو سلبي. It's a nice colloquial expression to know. It's a slang expression. سلبي usually means negative. Someone who's like, you know, negative. Yeah, and nags a lot and all of that. Yeah, you know. سلبي. راسو سلبي, or even if I say just without راسو سلبي, sometimes we use it in a positive way, totally different than, totally different from a person who's negative. It's a way to say he's cool. راسو سلبي, he has a cool head. يعني, yeah, he's cool. Not cool as like cool and speaks slowly. No, cool in the like, yeah, I'm really cool in a good way. So راسو سلبي, he has a cool head. Okay, it's a fun head basically. راسو سلبي, or just سلبي. Sometimes when I see something like a situation that is even like is even fun or cool, I say إيش سلبي. I don't mean to say negative. I just mean to say it's really cool. Okay, so راسو سلبي. Now you're gonna see a typical Lebanese woman. The way she speaks is also like typical Lebanese. Look at that. The way she speaks really is so typical like the women in Lebanon. السقافي مهمة كتير بالنسبة له. That's how she said it, you know. السقافي. سقافي يعني, usually it means culture. سقافي. But it doesn't mean culture in this, she doesn't mean culture in this case, but she means like being, I always forget this word. Is it cultivated? Like to have general knowledge and, you know, to be cultured, I think. Write it in the comment box so I can check what's the right word for this in English. So that's سقافة. And really, like, Lebanese people are usually, like, well-educated and, like, they have general knowledge and they really care about these things. So سقافة مهمة. مهمة يعني important in the feminine form because سقافة is a feminine word too. So السقافة, you see, I'm not saying السقافة because the fa here is a sun letter, so we don't pronounce the lam. Just say السقافي. السقافي مهمة. And notice we put our adjectives after our nouns. السقافي مهمة يعني being cultivated or education or culturedness, whatever, that's a noun, that's why. مهمة is important, كتير, very important. مهمة كتير بالنسبة لإلو. بالنسبة لإلو, according to him. In the feminine form, it's بالنسبة لإلا. You can say بالنسبة إلو, you see, or you can also say بالنسبة لإلو. They both mean the same thing. It doesn't change the meaning. بالنسبة إلو or بالنسبة لإلو. And in the feminine form, you will say بالنسبة لإلا, according to her, or for her, or for him. Okay? So, يلا, let's play.
بيقتل حلو يعلم أولاده وبيستفيد عطول من كل الفرص.
Okay, so بيقتل حلو, they said. You can also pronounce it بيقتل حالو, he said. بيقتل, he kills, حالو, himself. بيقتل حالو, he kills himself. In the feminine form, you say بتقتل, she kills. بتقتل حالا. she kills herself. بيقتل حاله. He kills himself. بتقتل حاله. She kills herself. لا يعلم. يعلم. يعلم يعني to teach. لا يعلم or to educate, of course. لا, the لا here means so that or in order to or to. لا يعلم so that he teaches or he educates. ولاده, his kids. بيقتل حاله لا يعلم ولاده. He kills himself to educate his kids. It's a way to say he goes out of his way to teach his kids. He does whatever is impossible, but like it's inevitable that they have to teach their kids. Okay, so بتقتل حاله. You can also say here لا تعلم in the feminine form, لا يعلم in the masculine form, لا تعلم in the feminine form. So بتقتل حاله تتعلم ولاده. ولاده in the feminine form. Okay, بتقتل حاله لا تعلم ولاده. Or you can also hear the لا, by the way, you can replace it with so many letters. You can say تتعلم ولاده would be 100% the same. لا يعلم ولاده or تعلم ولاده 100% the same. You can say كرمال يعلم ولاده, كرمال يعلم ولاده, so that he teaches his kids. You can also say حتى يعلم ولاده, so that he teaches his kids. Okay, some people say عشان. I don't like to use the word عشان. It also means the same thing. The لا, the تا, the كرمال, the حتى, and the عشان all mean the same thing. They all mean in order to, or so that, or to. So بيقتل حاله لا يعلم ولاده وبيستفيد. بيستفيد يعني he benefits from or he takes advantage of. بيستفيد. بيستفيد. بيستفيد عطول, always. By the way, when you say عطول, sometimes it means like straight. Like if you're asking for directions, you say مثلا ما بعرف مثلا المستشفى من وين. مثلا you can say يروح دغري أو عطول. عطول يعني straight on. But عطول here means always. بيستفيد عطول. He always benefits from or he always takes advantage of. بيستفيد عطول من of or from كل every or all الفرص. من كل الفرص. فرص يعني opportunities. In the singular form it's فرصة. In the plural form it's فرص. فرصة, فرص, opportunity. But also فرصة and فرص means days off. Okay, maybe because it's an opportunity for you to have fun and rest. Maybe it's related. So فرصة, opportunity, فرص, opportunities. بيستفيد عطول من كل الفرص. And he benefits or takes advantage always of or from كل الفرص, of all opportunities. In the feminine, what are you going to say? You're not going to say بيستفيد, right? You're going to say, who knows, write it down. بتستفيد. بتستفيد. She benefits from. بتستفيد عطول من كل الفرص. You know what you can do, guys, for homework? You can rewrite this passage in the comment box. And whatever I'm changing from masculine to feminine, you can rewrite the passage in the feminine form. What do you think? That's good homework. يلا, let's continue.
خلاص إذا منه متعلم ثلاث لغات بيحكي
من كتر ما صار مرق بإيش صار عنده مناعة.
مش مناعة, قدرة.
Okay, let me just repeat and make it shorter.
من كتر ما صار مرق بإيش
متعلم ثلاث لغات بيحكي إذا منه متعلم ثلاث لغات بيحكي.
Look what he said. إذا منه. إذا means if. منو, he is not. منو, he's not. إذا منو متعلم. متعلم, educated. إذا منو متعلم. By the way, I use معلم, educated. معلم, it's exactly the same thing. معلم, educated. متعلم or معلم, same thing. إذا منو معلم or إذا منو متعلم, if he's not educated, تلت لغات بيحكي. تلت لغات, languages in the singular, of course you know it's لغة, لغة العربية for example. لغة, لغات, three languages بيحكي, he speaks. So what is this man saying? He's saying that يعني, he's saying all the Lebanese speak so many languages, يعني the one who's not educated speaks three languages. Imagine that person who's educated. You see what he's saying? Like he's saying like Even if you're not educated, as a Lebanese, you know three languages. That's the minimum. You know, it's a way to say that's the least, basically. If he's uneducated, he knows three languages already. بيعرف ثلاث لغات أو بيحكي ثلاث لغات. Okay. إذا منه متعلم أو إذا منه معلم تلت لغات بيحكي. Three languages he speaks. Or you can say, of course, بيحكي تلت لغات. But why did he put تلت لغات before? To emphasize on three languages he speaks. You know, instead of saying he speaks three languages. Now here, the next one is, let's see. I'm going to repeat a bit.
من كل الفرص.
إذا منه متعلم تلت لغات بيحكي.
من كتر ما صار مرق بإيش صار عنده مناعة.
Okay, look at this one. It's a little bit difficult to explain this in English, to translate it, because it doesn't exist. But let's try. من كتر ما. Okay. كتر means a lotness. A lot, like كتير, a lot. And the كتر is a lotness. I don't even know if you say it like that in English. Like, it's a noun, basically. من كتر ما. Literally, as if you're saying something that doesn't make in English sense, any sense. But you're saying, from the allotness of. You know? Which means, okay, let me continue the sentence so it makes sense. من كتر ما صار مرق. Okay. مرق means literally passerby, which means he has gone by or he passed through, to go through, has gone through or to pass by. Okay. So, صار مرق, literally, صار on its own means he became. When you say صار مرق, it doesn't mean he became and he has gone through. Oh my God, how difficult it is to say this. صار مرق يعني he now has gone through a lot. When you put صار before a participle, you know. صار مرق بإشياء, in things, literally, بإشياء. I'd rather put the Hamza under it because in the Lebanese dialect we say إشياء, things. Okay, literally I'm saying here, from the allotness of him going through things, okay, صار عنده, عنده means he has, and صار means, again, he became, but because it's before عنده, it's like translating as he now has. صار عنده مناعة, مناعة يعني immunity. So, if I want to explain this sentence, let me just, first of all, before I explain it, remove my mask, okay? I'm going to translate it word by word and then say it. من كتر ما, from the allotness of him having gone through things, he now has any immunity. It's a way to say he has gone through so much that now he has immunity. Does it make any sense? من كتر ما. So that من كتر ما is nice to memorize because you can use it in other sentences, in other contexts. For example, من كتر ما بحبه, from the allotness of me, how much I love him, بحبه. من كتر ما بحبه, بموت فيه, I die in him, which means I die for him. موت فيه, you see? Like, I love him so much that I die for him. That's how it translates. Like, that something so much that blah, blah, blah. Okay? من كتر ما. يلا, memorize it. من كتر ما صار مرق, he has gone through اشياء, صار عنده مناعة. Okay, feminine. من كتر ما صارت feminine, she became, literally. Of course, here it doesn't mean she became, just forget it. It just means she now has or he now has. صارت مرق, the participle masculine, it becomes مرقة, feminine. Literally, the passerby or the goner through, which means has gone through, okay? صار مرق بإشياء, has gone through things. من كتر ما صارت مرقة بإشياء. She has been through so much that, what? صار عنده, not عنده. And by the way, the صار here doesn't change because it's just before عنده, which is a fake verb. Don't change صار, that stays fixed. Because it's not she became, we're saying she has. صار عنده. Just memorize. صار عنده, which means she now has. صار عنده مناعة, immunity. Okay, let me repeat the two sentences, the masculine and the feminine. Say it out loud with me. من كتر ما صار مارق بأشياء صار عنده مناعة. He has been through so much that he now has immunity. يلا feminine. من كتر ما صارت مارقة بأشياء صار عنده مناعة. يلا let's continue.
مش بس مناعة
قدرة
مش بس مناعة not only immunity قدرة ability مش بس مناعة مش not بس only مناعة immunity قدرة يلا say it with me guys okay مش بس مناعة not only مناعة not only immunity قدرة also ability
اللبناني عنده
قدرة كتير كبيرة. So اللبناني the Lebanese اللبناني اللبناني the Lebanese عنده has قدرة ability an ability a n the indefinite article by the way doesn't exist in Arabic. So you're just saying instead of an ability you're saying the Lebanese has ability. اللبناني عنده قدرة كتير كبيرة very big. اللبناني عنده قدرة كتير كبيرة. If you want to change it in the feminine form, what are you going to say? يلا write it. اللبناني عنده قدرة كتير كبيرة. What should I say? Let me check if somebody writes it. Anyways, it takes time for you to type. Oh my God, so many comments. I'm going to check them in a second. So instead of اللبناني, we have to say what? I'll wait. اللبناني عنده قدرة كتير كبيرة. I should say اللبنانية عندها قدرة كتير كبيرة. So اللبنانية I change the ya into a tema like I add a ta مربوطة to the ya. اللبنانية عنده becomes عندها she has. اللبنانية عندها قدرة an ability كتير كبيرة very big. Okay. And then they say
اللبناني قدرته أكبر
كتير ما بتتصور. اوكي. So اللبناني the Lebanese قدرته his ability. You see here I pronounced it قدرة. There is a سكون on the دال. Here I'm pronouncing it as if you're putting like a كسرة under the دال. قدرته his ability. قدرته. Feminine will be قدرته. So قدرته put an imaginary كسرة for the him قدرته بس for the feminine no it stays a سكون قدرته قدرته his ability قدرته her ability so اللبناني قدرته أكبر بكتير you're literally saying bigger with a lot which means much bigger أكبر بكتير that's how you say much bigger that's how you say much bigger, much smaller, much more beautiful, much more, much. Always you use the same structure. For example, أصغر بكتير, much smaller. أصغر بكتير, smaller with a lot. That's how you say much smaller, much bigger, okay? اللبناني, the Lebanese, قدرته, his ability, أكبر بكتير, is much bigger. مما, let's break مما down. مما is the combination of من which is of or from plus ما من instead of saying مِنْمَا we are merging them and we're saying مِمَّا from of what or from what here it means of what أكبر بكتير مِمَّا بتتصور much bigger than okay just translate it as than much bigger than أكبر بكتير مِنْمَا بتتصور Okay, much bigger than. So it's not just of or from, but it also means than. Much bigger than. A-N, right? أكبر بكتير من ما. Much bigger than. بتتصور. Now, that ما, why is it there? It's just because between من and a verb, I have to always insert a ما. Okay? But it's not changing the meaning. It's still meaning much bigger than. أكبر بكتير مما بتتصور. بتتصور usually means you take photos, but here it doesn't mean you take photos of, like, you, somebody's taking photos of yourself, yeah? Not you don't take photos of others, no, it's بتتصور, like أنا هلا عم بتصور if I'm posing, okay? But here بتتصور يعني you can imagine, it's not like to take photos or to be photographed basically, okay? It means to you مما بتتصور يعني much more than you can imagine. So the whole thing would be اللبناني, the Lebanese, يلا say it out loud with me guys. اللبناني قدرته أكبر بكتير مما بتتصور. مما بتتصور. So the Lebanese, his ability is, so the ability of the Lebanese basically, but what they're saying, اللبناني, the Lebanese, his ability is much bigger, أكتر بكتير مما than بتتصور, much bigger than you imagined. أكبر بكتير من ما بتتصور. Again, the من means then, but the من plus ما merges into مما. It also means then, but that ما, we have to insert it between من and the verb. Okay? So, أكبر بكتير مما بتتصور. هيدا اللبناني. He abbreviated as هاي اللبناني. هيدا اللبناني. Okay? So, هيدا اللبناني, that's the Lebanese. هيدا اللبناني. You can say هاي اللبناني. Yeah. Instead of هيدا اللبناني. That's the Lebanese. هيدا اللبناني. Okay? يلا. Let's read it once more. Very slowly. And then I'm gonna play it once and then we go. Okay? يلا. I'm gonna erase all the mess. And then I'm going to leave the link of this ad under the description box so that you can practice with me slowly and then you can play it to see if you're actually understanding it and you can check and you can write in the comment box, okay, how much did I understand? What percent did I understand? Just write it in the comment box later on, okay? Tell me if you understood 100%, 80%, 90%, 60%, 50%, okay? Yalla. Oh, I forgot to tell you about the title. مواصفات اللبناني. مواصفات. 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 Characteristics. مواصفات اللبناني. Guys, I need to open the door. One second. Sorry. So, مواصفات اللبناني, the characteristics of the Lebanese. مواصفات اللبناني. حربو, savvy, ذكي, intelligent. مزوق, good taste, well tasted, well mannered. بيضلو متفائل, he stays positive. كيف ما تكبو, بيجي واقف. No matter how you throw him, he ends up standing. كريم, generous. شجاع, courageous. وين ما بيروح, no matter where he goes, وين ما بيروح, بينجح, he succeeds. وين ما بيروح, بينجح. راسه سلبي, his head is cool. الثقافة مهمة كتير بالنسبة لإله. Being well educated, like well cultivated or having general knowledge. مهمة كتير, it's very important, بالنسبة لإله, according to him, for him, basically. بيقتل حاله, he kills himself, which means he does all what he can. ليعلم ولاده, to educate his kids. وبيستفيد, and he benefits from, or he takes advantage of, عطول, always, من كل الفرص, من كل الفرص, do it with the liaison, من كل الفرص. إذا منو متعلم, if he's uneducated, تلت لغات بيحكي, تلت لغات بيحكي. يعني even if he's uneducated, he speaks three languages. That's if he's uneducated, let alone if he's educated. من كتر ما صار, من كتر ما صار مارق بإشياء, he has been through so much that صار عنده مناعة. He now has مناعة. صار عنده مناعة. مش بس مناعة, not only مناعة، قدرة، ability. اللبناني عنده قدرة كتير كبيرة. The Lebanese has a very big ability. اللبناني قدرته أكبر بكتير مما بتتصور. The Lebanese's ability, which means the ability of the Lebanese, but here we're saying the Lebanese, his ability is much bigger, أكبر بكتير مما بتتصور, than you imagined. هيدا اللبناني, that's the Lebanese. Okay, يلا, I'll play it once. And actually, I remembered something. I want to show you something on TikTok. Do I have it? Do I not have it? I'm not sure. Not sure. Okay, I will put the link in the description box. You can watch it later on. Let's play it once more before we go. And keep your eyes on the text.
حربو.
زكي.
نزوي.
بضلوا متفاي.
كيف هتكبه بجوي؟
جوكر. كريم وشجاع.
وين ما بيروح بينجح.
وراسه سلم.
سعافة مهمة كتير بالنسبة له.
يقتل حلو يا علم ولاده. وبيستفيد عطول من كل الفرص.
إذا منه متعلم. ثلاث لغات بيحكي.
من كتر ما صار مارق بإيشة صار عنده مناعة.
مش بس مناعة. قدرة. اللبناني عنده قدرة كتير كبيرة.
اللبناني قدرته أكبر كتير مما بتتصور.
هلو.
Okay. So, your homework will be to write all of these. To say them out loud, always, even you can record yourself to see if your pronunciation is good. You can compare it to mine. You can do parrot work. This is the most important thing you can do to learn a language. You have to do parrot work so that you start pronouncing like a native speaker, you know. And what else did I want to say? So write the passage and under this video. And notice how fast they are speaking in the video, yeah? So you can start saying them slowly and then you can speed up. يلا and let me know here how much you understood and what's the percentage you understood. Thank you for saying the audio is good. Okay, thank you. حربو حربو yes. ذكي ذكية intelligent. كيفك أنا من good taste. مزوي yes. Okay. كبو بيجي بتجي واقف. Okay. No matter how you throw them, he keeps on standing. يعني resilient, that means resilient. Generous and courageous, كريم وشجاع. Thank you for writing them. I'm just checking them to see if it's incorrect. He succeeds. Thank you for watching. وأنا كمان مبسوطة. Let me know what's your name. I always say hi to you. I don't even know what's your name, fifth cat. Okay. Thank you. Yalla, you can watch it later on. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye now.